from what it's made of to what you can do with it if you work hard enough. Join me as I reveal to you 8 amazing facts about hair. Number 8. How strong is your hair? Now, this is an interesting topic because you might think that since you can pull out hair with your hands or with a simple comb, that your hair isn't strong. And individually, it isn't, as scientists state that a single strand of hair can only lift about 100 grams, which is still a lot for a single strand when you think about it. But the true strength of hair comes not in its singular strength, but its unified strength. What do I mean by that? Well, it's simple. If you were to weave together some of your hairs, its strength would go up, not unlike how rope is made. If you take threads and weave them together, they become a singular strand that has greater strength. So by that token, if you weave together your hairs in a significant way, you will find that your hair can hold up quite a bit. That's why you'll see certain acrobat performers doing tricks with their hair weaved in one spot and then tied to another object as they swing around. It may seem reckless, but they know the hair won't break. On an episode of MythBusters, Carrie Byron was charged with making a hair rope that would be used to let her propel down a prison wall to escape. And while it was a bit hairy in places, she did make it. It didn't break or snap under her weight. And some scientists say that if you were to take all the hair off the human head and weave it together, it could raise about 2 tons. Impressive. Most impressive. Number 7. The hairs on your head. When you wake up in the morning and you look in the mirror, you can't help but look at the hair on your head. Because whether it's large or small, long or short, it covers a big part of your hair space. And then when you decide to comb your hair, it's very common for you to accidentally pull out strands of your hair. And when you do that, it's clear that it didn't make too much of a difference on your head, because there are no major spots where the hairs used to be. So that begs the question, how many hairs are actually on your head? While it's impossible to know the exact number on each person's head, it's estimated that there's between 100,000 to 150,000 strands of hair on your head at any given moment, barring baldness, obviously. Think about that. Your head, just your head, just the top of your head, has over 100,000 strands of hair on it that comprises what you look like. Now again, there are obviously exceptions, but if you're looking at the average human with a decent set of hair, that's still a lot. And it makes you think about just how much certain other people have if they have flowing locks or a lot of curls or something else. So if you accidentally pull out some hair, don't fear, you've got plenty of replacements. Number 6. Loss and growth. Have you ever looked in your bathtub after a shower? Or in your sink after brushing your hair and see that there's a bunch of singular hairs down in the drain or near it? This is something that happens to just about everyone. But as I noted before, it's not exactly something you should fear per se, as your body has a good mechanism to ensure that you keep your locks, should you have them, and not notice the difference of the lost hairs. And I say that not just to emphasize how many hairs are on your head, but that your head makes sure that you have the replacements for those hairs in short order, as the moment you lose a strand of hair, the next one automatically starts growing. That's quite a backup system, and one that everyone should be appreciative of, especially since you lose about 50 to 100 strands of hair a day. So times that by an entire week, and you get up to 1,000 lost hairs a week. But since the hairs start to grow back immediately, you'll likely never notice. And that's because hairs are the second fastest growing tissue in the body. Only bone marrow grows faster. So no need to fear. Your head of hair is safe, for now. Before we continue, be sure to like the video and subscribe to our page for our weekly videos. Number 5. Gender equality. Let's talk about something that hair can't do, which is actually rare when you consider all the things that it can do. As you know, every single human body is unique, even with twins, triplets, and on and on. And that means that the hairs on your head are unique as well, to the extent that they can hold traces of your DNA, which is why they're able to be used in police cases to solve crimes. However, if you look at the DNA of a hair, you'll notice that something very specific is missing, a marker to tell you whether the hair you're looking at is from a male or a female? That's fascinating, as the DNA from the hair contains all other information, and yet it doesn't contain that. It feels odd, doesn't it? But it may be because the hairs are something that can't or won't differentiate from males or females, because technically speaking, a hair could come from either. Men have long hair just like women, and women have facial hair at times just like men. So it could be that the body just didn't give them the gender markers because both sides have hair of all types. It's honestly hard to say. That being said, even without the genetic markers for genders, hair has been used to solve many crimes. Number 4. Keratin. Have you ever wondered what hair actually is? Yes, it covers your head, face, arms, legs, armpits, etc. But do you know what it is? Hair is made of a substance known as keratin, which is one of the reasons that it is so strong in various ways. However, what you might not know is that keratin is much more prevalent in our own world, as long as you know where to look. So where do you need to look? Well, to your own hands and feet, and to certain other animals. For you see, the very nails on your hands and feet are also made of keratin. In fact, they have an enhanced version called alpha keratin, which is why they grow in a specific way. They're always growing, and they're very strong because of how they're compacted together. Now, as for animals, there are many out there that have their own keratin deposits. When it comes to horses, their natural hooves are made of keratin. For deer, elk, rams, and more, their antlers or horns are made up of keratin as well, making the substance one of the strongest around given how hard those antlers and horns can be. So while it may not appear at first, your hair is pretty strong stuff. Number 3. How to make your hair grow faster. As noted earlier, your hair has a built-in system that makes it grow faster than nearly anything else on the human body, to the extent that it is the second fastest growing tissue on your body. But that being said, there are ways to make it grow even faster, depending on where you live. It's been proven that if you live in a warmer climate, your hair will grow faster. And by warm, I mean 70 degrees or higher on average, more or less. In contrast, if you live in colder areas, your hair will grow much more slowly. So why is that? Well, think about how your body works as a whole. When your body is warm, everything is relaxed, more loose. So by that token, your body flows more easily. You're able to move around more easily, and your hair can grow without restrictions. But in contrast, when you're cold, you're rigid. Things tense up without you wanting them to, etc. Your body restricts flow in some areas to help make sure that your body can maintain its core temperature, and that means it'll pull heat away from your head and thus making your hair grow shorter. The lesson here is that if you're hoping to grow your hair faster in a short amount of time, you may need to head to warmer climates. Oh, and if you've heard the myth that trimming your hair makes it grow faster, it's a myth. Hair doesn't work like that. It grows the moment you cut it, but it won't be accelerated by cutting it a certain way, which is why bad haircuts seem to last forever. Number 2. Hair color. Hair color is a very interesting thing, because most times it seems random, but it really all boils down to genetics. Oftentimes, if your parents have the same color, that's what you'll get, because the genes between them are so strongly linked in this fashion that the outcome is rather predictable. However, if your parents are of different hair colors, then it's really a coin flip which you'll get. While there are dominant genes and recessive genes, it's also true that sometimes the odds are just in your favor to get a different hair color. And depending on your lineage, it's also probable for you to get an entirely different hair color than both of your parents. It just depends on how the dice rolls in your favor. If you're curious, the most common hair color in the world today is black, not brown like you might expect. In contrast, the least common hair color in the world is red. And some speculate that without an abundance of redheads in the near future, that hair color will die out within a couple dozen generations. It's also a known fact that the blonde hair color is actually a rather new one to the world in terms of when it popped up, which is why the rumor of gentlemen prefer blondes popped up, because for many, the blonde hair color was something new and fresh versus what they had been seeing all the time before. Regardless though, do enjoy the hair color that you have. It's special, and it's part of what makes you, you. Number 1. The impact of hair in our world. When you think about it, our hair is one of the things that people are most often concerned about. Think about how you start your day. You make sure your face is washed, your teeth is brushed, and then you comb your hair. Many people refuse to leave their bathrooms without making sure that their hair is in tip-top shape. Heading to the beauty products world, there are dozens, if not hundreds, of products dedicated to making your hair the best it can be. Shampoos, conditioners, straighteners, curlers, and more. It's a massively profitable industry strictly because people want to take care of their hair. There are musicals and plays about hair. There's even a Marvel superhero named Medusa that has super-powered hair. Hair is a very important part of our world, and many people go to great lengths to make sure that's known. What did you think about these facts about hair? Did you learn something about them? Or did you already know all of this? Do you know other facts about hair that you think needs to be known? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time.